And some people, of course, accuse me of having, you know, also selfish interests in FDC. I cannot and no longer seek to be a leader in FDC. So what interest would I have in destabilizing a party?
During a press conference held on Katonga Road, Besigye accused Nandala Mafabi of spreading falsehoods regarding the purpose of the 300 million shillings he provided, refuting Mafabi's claims that the funds were intended for party agents in 2020.
When I received the box, I opened it. It contained brand new 20,000 shilling notes, packed, of course, in 20 millions, wrapped with polythene paper, with a Bank of Uganda label on each bundle, showing the number of the note, the numbers on each note in the bundle, the serial numbers.
He explained that he has no personal grudges against Nandala, which needed reconciliation of the committee. He also accused the FDC Secretary General of lying about the source of the dirty money. He narrated how the money got to him and the reasons Nandala gave to him before he handed it over. It was at this point that Besigye referred to Nandala as a liar, because at first he said the money was his, but he later changed his statement, saying the money was meant for the party activities.
My first concern came with the arrival of the money, because the money arrived at my home at 10 p.m. He rang me. He had told me he would send the money. We met here actually when he told me it was about 8 in the morning. But the man arrived at about 10 p.m. And he rang me saying that the other thing I talked about is about to arrive. And I said, but Nathan, where is it passing? Because this is curfew time.
Besigye also pinned the FDC party president, Patrick Amriat Oboy, of having received 280 million shillings around the same time.
I got slightly more details about some people to whom some of that money was given. One of whom was the party president, the Honorable Amriat Oboy, whom it was said had received 280 million. And so I thought it was helpful to begin with that one and see whether it was indeed true or not. I called the Honorable Amriat and we met, and I asked him, did you receive money from the Honorable Nandala? And he said, yes. I said, how much? He said, 280 million. Did he tell you where it came from? He said, no. But in NEC, we had passed a resolution that we should borrow money. So I assume that this is part of what was borrowed.
Besigye further criticized the Elders Committee report regarding the money, saying that the committee members didn't bother to make any attempt to establish the facts.
Neither in their findings nor in their recommendations did they seek to deal with the dirty money. Save as I have said, just recording what each one of us told them, and even then recording it in a biased way. So I don't think that the value of this report is even equal to the paper on which it is.
According to Besigye, the ongoing infights within the FDC party have rendered the party dysfunctional. He has therefore announced a massive mobilization across the country to free the party from the leadership of Patrick Oboy Amriat and Nandala Mafabi.
It is time, even as these wrangles are being sorted out, and as the liberation of the party processes are going on, it is a time that we also focus on the liberation of the country, so that the two are not, one is not to the exclusion of the other one.
Besigye noted that the party is currently under siege and that its members should rescue it, adding that there are plans by dissatisfied members of the party to mobilize others to rescue the party. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.